Have you ever tried or done something to bring more calm into your life and then it didn't go as planned? And then you were just left frustrated. Well, that was me in 2022 when in the spring, I planted a garden in honor of my dachshund who had passed. I named it the Molly Memorial Garden. It was great. I had a great time planting, tending to the garden. It was relaxing. It brought me great memories. But by the time summer came here in Arizona, it just scorched my garden no matter what I tried to do. So it failed. And now it's been over a year, but I thought, I'm not going to give up. I'm going to replant this garden, do it differently with the mistakes that I'm hoping I learned from. So maybe for you, it was a reading nook that you set up, but then you got interrupted every 5 minutes, so you could never finish a book. Or it was baking Saturdays and you wanted to have that time to relax, give those yummy baked goodies to your friends and families, but you know, the just Saturday just seemed to be swamped with different chores and tasks that had to be done. Or maybe it's a typical date night or a weekend travel or a big vacation where just the budget and the schedules just didn't work out. Well, we are going to push forward and create that thing that brings you calm, because your self-care is important. So let's learn along the way, maybe implement things that can work that didn't work last time. And so here I am with all the stuff that I bought from Lowe's. This is, I do have a couple plants that I need to put for my husband's Pilates studio, but you see I bought the dirt, and then we are going to head out to my garden area. Right, this is my patio area. I started out a little bit late. I slept in today. I did want to get up a couple hours earlier, but anyway, it's already 10:40 a.m. and 89 degrees, and yes, I live here in Arizona, so a lot of our yards are all rock, and that is my view, and I absolutely love it. That's actually why we got this house. When we saw it at night, and then we came back during the day, and I saw that view, and I was like, sold. Okay, so these are the raised beds that my friend gave me. She had moved to Sacramento, and so these are what I'm planting in these today. Think herbs. And I might just do all herbs here, or herbs. And then I do have a tomato and some peppers that I plan to do over there. I'm not sure if I'm gonna get to that today. And then look at my beautiful bougainvillea plant. And so that's my kitchen there where I film a lot. And I try to make this as level as possible, but you can see what's in here. No need to really clean that up. I'm just gonna put the dirt, and I think you could put a hose from underneath, turn it on, and then it would spray, but I'm not sure if I'll be using that. And then it's the same exact one. And as far as having this one here and that one there versus both of them in the middle, I thought that would just be better. It would just be going this way. I don't think it matters as far as the garden growing. So yes, I managed to kill the dragon fruit, the eggplant, but you can see a bunch of black pots. Those were all here, and those were my herbs. And they did actually really well for a while, a lot longer than the tomatoes and peppers I had planted there. And so I put those in pots. Over there was in the ground. So I know for sure I'm not doing the ground, no matter how much organic soil I had put in where I planted. And then the pots were okay, but I'm just going to try that. And you can see some of the plants here that I got. This is for my husband's studio. This is the tomato plant, I believe. And then here are the different herbs. Hi, Zoe. And these are the potting mixes that I got. This one is really heavy, so I'm not sure if I'm gonna be able to lift that by myself. Oh, that's Zoe's dog food. I'm trying to figure out how to store that. I had a big bucket before and I didn't really like it. I might put it in a 5 gallon bucket. So anyway, that's not part of the gardening. I have some citrus food there that I'll put for the lemon tree that is actually still growing. And then those are my tools. All right, I do know how to take care of indoor plants, and I know which ones do well in my house and where. I have a pathos here, and I do that to kind of hide the speaker, one up here, and I literally water these once a month, and These I've already, is propagate where you cut some off and replant? Then that was in my living room. Here I have this, I think it's a peace lily, and it's never grown more than this. I do have to fix that. This one is a calamansi plant that I'm trying to revive. That was from my parents' house. That's fake. I just put that in. I love it. And then I have this Dracaena. Yeah, I have three of them. That's the one I'm planting for my husband to bring to his workplace. And this one, I forgot the name. And I changed all my pots to black. And then there's another Dracaena, right? And then over here to other side, another one. And I used to have another plant here, but I was trying to keep it minimal. But you could see how, let's show you, when I walk in, I just love all the plants and the green, right? And along with my green chairs. Okay, let's plant the Dracaena in this pot. All right, we're done planting the Dracaena. And my friend gave me this really pretty gold watering can. I love it. And so I'm just gonna put some water in it to see how much the dirt compacts. And I will definitely have to get a dish for the bottom because I think this might drain. I'm just gonna test it out. And since this will be at my husband's Pilates studio, I think I'm gonna get some moss maybe from like the Dollar Tree and put it on top so that when, you know, people are there, they're not seeing like the top of dirt. It'll just look prettier. Okay, all right, then I'm just gonna move it over here so that it's like going towards the garage. Whenever I have to give my husband something to bring over there, I just put it over here as a visual cue for him. Okay, there you go. And now onto the snake plant. Okay, now we're going to do the snake plant. And it was $16.98 because it was in this, it's in this pot, which I really don't need the pot because I have this white one. But there was nothing available at that time when I was going to Lowe's. So I'm going to add some dirt, so it would be up like that. Took care of the Dracaenas and the snake plant, and now we're gonna head out. But before that, I just wanted to mention, hey, this is Zoe. If you haven't met her already, we've had her for 2 months. She's 5 years old, and yesterday I finally went and established her vet. So it's the same vet clinic, different vet that we used to have for our other dog. So she got a shot yesterday here in her left shoulder. I think it's a little bit better. She was definitely sore because I accidentally pet her here and she kind of squealed, but I think she's better now. I called the groomer, so I wanted to establish that because we need to get her groomed. I've never had a multi-poo before, and we used to have a short-haired dachshund, which was very easy to just bathe. But once I bathed her, I tried to comb her, and then she just could not take that. I mean, I don't know if it was a bad brush, but I bought it specifically for her. Anyway, waiting for the mobile groomer to call back. So she has all her shots, but she also had the leptospirosis. Leptospirosis shot. It's a vaccine. I think she has to have it twice a month in between because I want to take her hiking. And since this video, I wanted to mention that because since this video is about, doing something so that you can have calm or self-care in your life. That's one thing I want to do with Zoe is to go hiking. And so here in Arizona, that vaccine is recommended because it's a bacteria that's passed on by urine and wildlife. And since we will be hiking the trails and the mountains, there's wildlife there. And so that's why she got the shot. But anyway, this is my fluffy wuffy. Yeah. And then I will be doing a video for all her hiking gear and my hiking gear. It's not a lot, but it's definitely stuff you'll need for, like a 4-hour hike or a 2-hour hike. All right, friends, it's 96 degrees now, and there's still shade in this area, but eventually it will be all sun. So what I'm gonna do is take the plants out and kind of lay them out. So this is tomatoes. I'm just putting it there for now. Oh, I'm sorry, this is green bell pepper. And then one of the mistakes I made was I took all these and I thought, okay, I know what cilantro looks like. I know what tomatoes look like, or what a tomato plant looks like, or what curly parsley, flat parsley looks like. And so I threw them away. And even though I still kind of knew what they are, it was just too much brain power that I had to use each time. Or if I had to ask, let's say, honey, go get, can you go snip off some cilantro? He wouldn't know cilantro from flat parsley, curly parsley, whatever, because he doesn't know that, or he's not the cook in the family. He loves to barbecue, which is great. But so that's what I'm gonna change. So I'm probably going to laminate these or make something. For now, I think I'm gonna laminate them to protect them a little bit from the rain and the heat. But then I'm gonna figure out something else. I saw these things on Amazon where they're kind of more metal or ceramic that you could write on it. I've also thought of using my label maker, but I think with the sun it's going to be too much. So for now I'm going to keep these and then eventually laminate or figure out something for that, but not for this video. And the reason I'm saying this is because, we're learning from our mistakes. So that was one of my mistakes, was throwing these away and just making myself more confused than I need to be. And I wanted it to be something that would relax me, but that part stressed me out. So when you're redoing your thing, whether, let's say it's a reading nook, think about some things that would work better. Like maybe you have to make you feel more relaxed. Maybe you want your favorite teacup as part of your reading nook. And then the other thing is, if I labeled these correctly and my husband went out here to cut some cilantro, let's say I was making pico de gallo, the nice thing there is now he becomes, I don't have dirt on my face. He becomes part of this thing in my life that is, my self-care or something that brings calm into my life. So he becomes part of that. And so let's say with your reading nook, if you were interrupted every 5 minutes, how can you integrate your family or whoever lives in your home to support you or to support that part of that area in your home that has a specific purpose, and that purpose is to recharge you, right? Maybe it's when they help you set it up, or they help you find the right basket, or a pretty basket, or decorate the basket where you're going to put your books. Or maybe you go out and you find that favorite tea set that you're going to use for your reading nook. And I found that, because I did that with my reading nook, my daughter would, when she saw me that I'm reading, she'd ask me, oh, would you like some tea? And it was just something that she liked doing for me, because she knew that that reading nook was special to me. Or you can find a book together, and or your favorite blanket, or determine, you know, choose which space in your house you're going to put your reading nook in. So I hope that makes sense. That's my, you know, that's my tip, is not just, especially, you know, if you don't live alone, but you need a space to recharge, or you need something to recharge you, whether it's your craft room, same principle, you know, they can be part of choosing the space, finding the markers, finding, you know, maybe that specialty paper that's just from them as a gift to you, that they support you and your craft space. So hope that makes sense. You know, integrate your family into what helps you in your self-care, in you relaxing, in you bringing calm into your life. All right, so let's continue, and I'm just going to, like I said, take everything out and lay it out. So this is Thai basil, so I'll just put it there, okay, and see what fits. Okay, all these will go to that other part there, so I'll put it there, but I won't be showing me planting it today. I might do it in another video, but basically it's tomatoes, bell peppers, serrano pepper, lettuce, spinach. This one is Thai peppers, so I might keep that there, because in my mind that's more like a garnish versus like a part of, you know, it's in like sauces and things like that, as far versus like a tomato or a pepper, which is kind of part of the meal, more of a vegetable. But you can see I have some spaces left there, and that was on purpose, because when I went to go shop for these herbs, they didn't have cilantro or flat parsley. But here I have peppermint, and then this is Italian oregano, curled parsley. Can you guys guess without looking at the name? Garden sage. How about this one? Thai basil. And then this one, you would know this, sweet basil. Okay, so like I said, I plan on having flat parsley and cilantro here. And you could see how, I don't know the name of this product. I think I'll see if my friend can let me know. And then, I mean, some, you know, the Arizona sun beats up the wood, so I don't know how long this will last. I might have to just paint the outside here, at least as part of another project. But you can see each spot has kind of a lower thing. I don't know if that really matters. It's kind of more the drain spot, but that's where I'm gonna aim for putting the herbs, and you can see the kind of the spacing. So what I'll do is I'll try to fit, I'll put the dirt up to here and see how that works. So I think I'm going to keep the Thai pepper here and maybe add, see if, you know, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, I have 7 more herbs that I can put in here. So let's see how that goes. I might add another chili pepper here, or Thai pepper, then I would have 6 more. But for now, you know, I'm only planting this section. I'll tell you, it's already feeling good that I'm going to have a garden. And so I laid these out. These are going to be where my tomatoes are, and I do have some, I don't even know what those are called. Whatever. Can you let me know what those are called? I just call them the metal. Okay, so I have pepper here, jalapeno. I'll put the red bell pepper in front there. Oh, I have tomatillo heirloom. Okay, yeah, I think I might do another tomato here, or onion, and then jalapeno. I might do another bell pepper here. So this is all or like pepper. Like instead, there's jalapeno, I might get serrano pepper here. Yeah, I might get another type of tomato or the same one. So these are both husky red. So I might get another tomatillo heirloom and a serrano pepper. So here's the lettuce. So I want to do both of these lettuce and both romaine lettuce. And then this is red romaine. And then this is spinach. And then I might do onion here. So we're done, right? So just a bunch of romaine lettuce, because I use these two lettuces a lot. And so when I thought about this garden is what vegetables do I use a lot of? Because I can't do my whole backyard. So these are kind of the main ones: tomatoes, peppers, lettuce, spinach, and then hopefully onion will work out. Okay, I'm gonna water these for now. But like I said, I won't plant it. I'll probably plant tomorrow. I gotta get that other part finished. I just put some water because they have been, actually I bought these last week because I happened to be at the garden center getting those plants for my husband. So I went ahead and picked these up. So I wouldn't probably have picked these up for another week or two. But the guy there said like, yeah, people are starting to garden. Once the temperature went down 100, people started coming back. I think it's supposed to be 102 today, I'm not sure. Okay, so just have some, get that wet a little bit, oops. All right, gonna put the dirt in now. And so what I'll do is I'll place these over here exactly how I want them placed here on the right, so I don't forget. All right, guys, it's almost 1 p.m. I started at 10:40, 11, 12. So it's been, is that right? About 2 hours and 20 minutes. I did pause for a little bit, probably about 30 minutes worth. So let's say it's been about an hour, 15 minutes of filming and doing this. And again, it would take a lot shorter time if I wasn't filming. Because filming, you got to think of the different angles, right? Okay. So let's hope I can carry this big honka monka bag of dirt. Ah, oh, okay. Yep, watch my back. Okay, as I do get back in, because that one hurt my back a little bit at the very end. Okay, ooh, that looks like good dirt. I hope I'm doing this right. I think I am. All these plants and dirt, I think I spent about, I want to say $275, maybe $300. I can't remember. I'd have to look at the receipt. Like I said, I wonder, does it matter? I don't think I need to put any covering at the bottom, right? I am grateful to my friend for giving me this, because I was looking at raised beds for a while. Okay. I mean, it just takes a lot of dirt, right? Oh, this looks nice. So, I mean, I know raised beds cost money, so I figured this was so nice to get this, not spend that money, try again, you know. So even if you're trying again with something, you get stuff for free, you know. Maybe instead of, like, if you don't need to get a new product or replace a new product, just think more of the system. Maybe the area where you're reading nook just wasn't a good place because is in the middle of a high traffic area in your home, and everyone will pass that space all day long. So you will get interrupted every 5 minutes. Oh, I love the feel of this. Okay, looking good. I think I'll put one more bag. All Okay, you can see that this bag is also raised bed soil. It's not as heavy, and I wonder if it's because it doesn't say organic on it. Oh no, it says 100% organic. I don't know, they're the same. They were the same volume. 1.5 cubic feet net contents. Yeah, 42.47 liters, so yeah. Let me just confirm. Oh, this is 2.2 cubic feet. This is 1.5. Okay, maybe that's the difference, the 0.5. Let's see how this soil looks like. Oh, sorry. You could not see that. Okay, it says 1.5 cubic feet. This is also organic. I don't know if that showed. This is 2 cubic feet, and it totally says organic here, organic plus. So I decided I'll put that other one over here on the left so the soils can be evenly set up. Okay, this looks good. All right. Oh, perfect. Just the right height. Gonna crush up the dirt a little bit, the soil. Okay, mix it up. So it's not like that other soil's on top. And I just picked the soil that was there. I mean, there was like maybe 4 options at the most. I can't remember, but it's not like I had a ton of options, and it was kind of hot that day. I didn't want to stand around waiting for an answer, asking an answer, because I was also shopping for all the different plants and that got really hot. Okay, but it's nice today. You know, for us here in Phoenix, 96, we're good. Under 100, we're like, yes, it's cold. Listen, seriously, we think 75 is cold. 74, I mean, for sure. 40, 50 is freezing. Okay, I'll put these back where I'm going to plant them. Of course, now I can't see that particular hole, but you kind of have a gist of where it is. And just space them out as evenly as I can. Let me know in the comments below if you have a garden. What works well for you? Do you use a raised bed? What's your climate? And especially if you live in Arizona and you have, or Phoenix, because parts of Arizona, not every part of Arizona's like Phoenix. Ups in Flagstaff, it gets nice. Yeah, let me know your tips for planting a garden here in Arizona. So I got my narrower little shovel there. Oh, that looks really good. Feels good. Okay. And I'm gonna just put this here, the little tag here to the left until I can finish all those. Keep that plastic over there. Okay. That looks good. All right, guys, this is my little raised bed garden. And then I planted the two. The other one obviously took a little bit more time. The other one was really simple, the snake plant. But here you go, Thai basil, sweet basil, garden sage, curly parsley, peppermint, Italian oregano, and all that other stuff over there that I'll be taking care of in another video. I feel good. This really was actually relaxing. I love the feel of dirt. I love the idea that I'm gonna harvest from this and use it for the things that I'm gonna cook for my family. Okay, as I'm planting this, I realize that I need, if there's Italian oregano, is there like another oregano? But I need rosemary, thyme. But like I mentioned, I have at least 8 slots. If I'm gonna put the Thai chili pepper here, right? I'll probably put on the far left. I'll put 2 of them because I really want some chili pepper, Thai chili pepper. I might put oregano, regular oregano and flat parsley. Ooh, yeah, I need to probably take, I should move the sage. I'll probably move the sage to over here. So if I have oregano, flat parsley, then I have sage, cilantro, rosemary, thyme, and I got 2 more. Let me know in the comments below what other 2 herbs I should have. Or if you want to tell me all 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, I have 8 more. But I think for sure I want to have another oregano, flat parsley, cilantro, rosemary, thyme. That's 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. I need 3 more. Let me know in the comments below 3 more herbs that I can plant. And also let me know what area of your home, what is that thing that you're going to redo, try again, push through, make it happen, create the calm that you need in your life. Let me know that and the 3 herbs, and I will see you in the next one. Bye.